Hey, I'm Billy Drain with Miller Industries, and today we're back in Large Wrecker assembly area. I want to talk about some preventative maintenance items, namely on the Large Wrecker control stations. What we have here is a Century style control station. If you'll notice, the Century style valve and control station, the valve is located up towards the front of the wrecker underneath the main boom pivot. The control stations come out via a cable control system, both on the driver and on the passenger side. Today we're looking at the passenger side control station, and we're going to talk about the lubrication of that control station. So I wanted to bring you guys back in here to the assembly area so that you could see the construction of the control station before it's a finished product with all the covers that go on it in the dress out area. So if you see here with the control station, the rod and linkage, you have a rod that runs the whole width of the control station. Each one of the levers rides along this rod and has an individual brass bushing in between each rod. There's a spacer here at the end that keeps the slack out of it. And then at the middle, this is a support that keeps that rod from bending when using the controls. You'll notice that each one of the control levers has a grease fitting at the base of the control lever. Here in the assembly area, before it has the cover panels placed on it, it's very easy to see that grease fitting, so I want to show you in this open format. And that's what we're going to talk about lubricating. So now let's move to a unit that's a little bit further in the process, and we'll show you exactly how to lubricate those control handles. So the control station lubrication is very important. This is something that needs to be done on a monthly basis using a medium pressure lithium grease. We've got a lot of feedback from the field, and sometimes when using the wireless remote, the operator will complain that the remote is sticking. By using the wireless remote, we're using the electric air solenoids to operate these manual controls. If they're not lubricated properly, you can cause the controls to stick and maybe not disengage when you release your finger off the button. So for example, if I'm using my underlift, I hit underlift out, it's going to move that control rod in that direction. When I release that function, if it's not lubricated properly, that lever may not return to center. And the other thing is, because these control handles are on a single rod, if they're not lubricated correctly, when you engage one function that's next to another, that handles may stick together, running multiple functions at the same time when you're only looking to operate a single function. So we're going to start and show you how to lubricate this control station. What we're going to do is simply move the control handle away from us to be able to expose that grease fitting, then place the grease gun in there. You'll want to use a grease gun that has a flexible tube to be able to get into that grease fitting. We're going to give each one of those control rods a 3 to 4 pump lubrication. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe to our news feed to receive all the latest tips and tricks from Miller Industries.
This video is for product demonstration purposes only and is not intended for training or instructional purposes. Situations vary, and operators should rely on their own professional knowledge and safety procedures when conducting actual recoveries.
Miller Industries, the world leader in towing and recovery equipment.